All right, so we're gonna do a golf cart tour. Anyone have any final words?
How
do you say your name?
Giacomo.
Giacomo.
Which is the Italian version of Jack or James.
There you go.
Your choice.
All right, here we go.
Let's do it, man. Let's do it.
Get in the car.
Let's tour some shit.
I like that there's somebody with an actual camera, not an iPhone. That's cool.
Yeah, right.
It was the city center of the ancient city during imperial times.
Okay.
Can you hear Chip?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Tell me if I need to raise my voice.
Raise your voice.
All right.
Yell.
That was quick.
Much louder.
At the end of these 3 hours, I'll be like, oh shit.
Yeah. You will.
I'll check it out.
So I figured got that close.
The ancient city of Rome.
Yeah.
So there's a whole city buried underneath our feet. And I'll show you
some. Oh, really?
Yeah, absolutely. So basically, the city of Rome grew on top of the ancient city. It's like grew on top of itself.
Isn't that amazing?
It's,
I didn't know that.
And we'll see more than one example of that.
Did not want to wave high.
Right. Because they excavated and tried to create a subway station, but they, as soon as they started, they found ruins and then continue on digging and they found 4 ancient Roman temples.
No.
So they keep on digging and eventually they created an archaeological site.
Okay. For heaven's sake.
And then studies because they brought them back up. They found these on the ground.
How many thousands?
This is almost 2,000 years.
Okay. 2,000 fucking years old.
But imagine everyone, we would have to destroy the whole city center. And we would keep on finding the city. Roads, buildings, basilicas. Mussolini used to speak to the people during the war.
Wow.
He used to come out of the balcony that is on the other side of the bus. The came out until the 1930s. This was all buried. So actually, was Mussolini starting to reform Mussolini and keep on going in this direction to destroy the buildings, move the people, destroy the building, and started excavating and revealing all these monuments and this room that were underneath.
It's 113 after Christ.
Basically, this era was built by a great emperor. So when this era was built, it's the period when Rome and the Roman Empire is at its maximum expansion. And basically, the empire, he's from Spain, nobody really knows him. He goes all the way to Dacia, the mother Romania in Eastern Europe. He led a military campaign there. And he comes back with a lot of slaves and, even more important, a lot of money, big treasures. So he was able to then start excavating the hill on that side, so create this flat space, and start in building this massive area,
so
which
the
is...
the subway is out now.
The subway? The subway is...
the subway project got canceled.
This was a market, but then they found a lot of ladders, a lot of narrow spaces that were not really good for carts or horses.
It looks modern.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The whole structures were really modern. You imagine that every arch was an entrance.
and they had numbered seats, so it was really
easy.
It was really modern. They estimated that they could move the whole 80,000 people. In case of emergency, they could evacuate, move the whole people in like 13 minutes. Because every arch is a gate. Talking about being modern, but how do you say modern music? That's green.
Yeah, way ahead of the time.
Oh, yeah. And they were ahead of the time for many, many.
More massive than I thought it would be.
It is.
And they took all the marble from this structure, and the church took all the marble, the statue, a lot of material from here, and they reused it to build St. Peter, the Vatican. Yes. Oh yes. So you can see all the every arch had a statue in the middle. Not this row, the external row, every arch had a big marble statue, all of that is gone. Because now this is the internal circle. Because the external structure collapsed after an earthquake.
Oh, I see.
So this was already the internal side of the structure. It's basically like a modern stadium that has a corridor and it's all around it.
When was that earthquake that
Many earthquakes, but the one that destroyed this part was in the middle of 1800. Then they built a wall to contain the structure, so to not let it fall. Yeah. And this on the right, in the dark, this is the part on the center of this area that's the widest hill in the center of Rome. Beverly Hills of ancient Rome, where all the powerful and ravaging rule was the reality that didn't exist after the entire collapse. They had a lot of money, a lot of power. After that, it was like dark ages. Nobody really ruled the city until the Vatican.
Structure.
And
top.
bugging people. But they built during medieval times, as I said. But now, still now, people live there.
Keep going, man. You're doing good.
So let's go to the train fountain.
To see Trevi Fountain at night. That's what we're doing.
tonight would be an accident.
No, please, don't say
okay, guys, I'm going home. Bye-bye. Your little house?
No, just a little house.
What is this park called?
Borghese.
Yeah, Borghese Park.
Borghese.
Villa Borghese.
Borghese Park.
B-R-G-H-E-S-I.
there was a place for already for study, and then it became a school.
Thank you. Yeah.
Come back here. Yeah? Yeah, we're going to have to come back here. All these people are a little better dressed than I am.
It's like a rich person party.
Square.
Oh, sorry.
Thank you.
advisor.
Of course.
Yeah, we're going to upload a bunch of videos of you.
Oh, thanks.